Hi, I'm Andrew Wasson. Thanks for tuning in to another video lesson here on YouTube. And I gotta say, welcome to part four, the final chapter in our series on how to play over a typical jazz tune. And what we are going to do in this segment is to cover the percussion's role. Now, there's an old saying that you can cover up weaknesses in guitar, bass, and even vocals, but you can't hide a bad drummer. The drum track, I think, is basically the cornerstone of your band. I'm not talking about solo artists or solo acts or experimental music or even classical stuff. I'm talking about music where the drums play a key role. You know, I once worked with a horn player who made an interesting comment, and it went something like this. Good drummers are like sunlight passing through a window. It's taken for granted until it gets cloudy. So I've found this many times in the past that when you're working with a drummer and that drummer is just super solid, you don't really recognize how valuable that is until the drummer changes and you're working with somebody who isn't quite on the same level. And I really believe that when the bass, the drums, and the rhythm guitar play as a unit and everybody's locked together, everybody's tasteful, and everybody's having a good time, I think the songs for your set that you're playing are going to just simply be far easier to play. Now, in a moment, we'll post a link for you to jump over to drummer Aaron Edgar's channel and watch his video lesson covering various grooves and feel concepts for playing over a typical jazz piece. Aaron will be covering how to develop your note placement and how to work on your pulse. Plus, he'll be diving a little bit into dynamics with some interesting ways to modify your cymbal sounds for certain situations. So whether you're a drummer, a bassist, or a guitarist, I'm sure you'll find the percussion lesson coming up in a moment very interesting. So without further ado, here comes the link to Aaron's video lesson.